Although she leaned to bear the human load, although she leaned to bear the human load, yes, that is the whole purpose of incarnation. She accepts the conditions of mortality, the sorrow, grief, ignorance, fate, all those things. She, her walk keeps still.
It is the meaning of unborn.
Unborn minds, they are always there. They have not taken birth. They are always there. Yeah, we have seen the earlier two unborn, you see. Unborn mind means of the immortals. The immortal. Unborn minds was hers. Although she leaned to bear the human load, her walk kept still the measure of the gods. Obviously, although she is living in this terrestrial world, in this ignorant world, in this sorrowful world, in this ignorant, she is unborn. Her walk still kept the measure of the gods. Earth's breath had failed to stain that brilliant glass. So he is giving the example of stained glass. Earth's breath, see, you breathe on a glass and then the glass gets stained, but here it doesn't happen. That is the example of impunity. She is immune to all these kind of things. Earth's breath had failed to stain that brilliant glass. That is exactly the example of this impunity, you see. Unsmeared with the dust of her mortal atmosphere, it still reflected heaven's spatial joy. That glass, that mirror, is always reflecting heaven's joy. Whereas our earthly glass, when you blow, it gets smeared in nothing. Almost the saw who lived within her light, almost the saw who lived within her light, her playmate in the sempiternal sphere, descended from its unattainable realm in her attracting advanced luminous wing. The white fire, dragon bird of endless bliss, drifting with burning wings, a dream. Heaven's tranquil shield guarded the mission child. Now, guarded the mission child, again, it is an elaboration of that word, impunity. No adverse forces, no calamitous events are going to affect her. She is firm-willed in her mission. In other words, this child has come here, heavens has come here with a mission. And that mission is guarded by heaven, by heaven's shield. She is guarded by heaven's shield, and that is the kind of a protection she gets against all the mortal conditions she receives. Almost they saw, these gods. Her walk kept still the measure of the gods. Almost they saw, these gods saw, who lived within her light. These gods are living within her light. They are surrounded by her light. And what do they see? They see her playmate of the sempiternal sphere, of the heavenly sphere. They see her playmate descended from its unattainable realms. Who is this playmate? Love. Descended from its unattainable realm. In her attracting advanced luminous wake, how the white fire, dragon bird of endless bliss. Suddenly the poetry is different again. This is surrealistic. White fire, dragon bird, surrealistic, you see. It is not just mystical, it is not just spiritual, it is not just symbolic, it is surrealistic. White fire, dragon bird of endless bliss. White fire, absolutely white without any stain. Because of the full immunity it has. No stain can come. She is a glass on which no smearing can come, no stain can come. So she is a white here. Fire, burning, white, glowing, always blazing. Dragon bird, which can wing high up in sky. Dragon bird of endless bliss. Endless bliss. So it goes on and on and on. In other words, this bird is a bird of bliss. Ananda, Pakshi, he the bird of bliss, You see, she is deprived of it. In fact, he says bliss, ananda. The white fire, dragon bird of endless bliss, drifting with burning wings above her day. So it is that bird of ananda, that bird of joy, of ecstasy, of divine bliss, it is that bird which is protecting her. Therefore, there is no question of any sorrow coming to her. Because the bird of bliss itself is protecting her. Very question of sorrow and sadness and all that. No mournful at all, you see. What a description. Almost the star who lived within her light, her playmate. So, almost, gods cannot really see the totality, even though they are gods. Of her divine nature, of her divine qualities. Almost, you see. The star who lived within her light, her playmate in the sentinel sphere descended. Yes, he has come down here, playmate, because he has to come here for the game. From its unattainable realm, in her attracting, advanced, luminous way, it is because of her he is attracted and he has come down here. The white fire, dragon bird of endless flame, drifting with burning wings above her day. What a dense line, you see. Drifting with burning wings above her days. Heaven, tranquil shield, guarded the mission child. So the whole description is again that elaboration of that immunity of impunity. Nothing is going to affect her. Nothing is going to touch her at all. Because heaven itself guarding this child. And it is the bird of love, bird of bliss, who is drifting above her head. Because of his bird of bliss, there is no question of she succumbing to any sadness, any sorrow. See, again, this is a very powerful simile, very powerful simile, and very surrealistic kind of a simile, you see. A glowing orbit was her early term, glowing orbit. Orbit means not the mechanical orbit, but the sphere of activity. Orbit here stands for your sphere of activity. The glowing orbit was her early term. Well, it is she is going to work in that. Years like gold remain to the gods that pass. Gold remain to the gods. The gods are wearing golden robe, and when they pass, they flutter this robe. Her youth sat throned in calm felicity. Always happiness, always joy, because the bird of bliss is drifting over her head. Well, although it is so, but joy cannot endure until the end. Now the story has to begin. Till then, no mournful ray had touched her. See, now that mournful is going to be. But joy cannot endure until the end. There is a darkness in terrestrial thing that will not suffer long. Too glad a note. She has come with all that bliss, with all that ecstasy, with all that happiness. But she has to meet also sorrow and suffering of this world. Only when she meets sorrow and suffering of this world can she remove the sorrow and suffering of this world. She has to meet that, you see. Therefore, but joy cannot endure until the end. There is a darkness in terrestrial things. Well, this is inherently there. You can't remove the darkness. It is inherently there, the darkness. It is in the very DNA of the earth, of the terrestrial things, that there is bound to be darkness, because these are all inconscient born of inconscience. So the darkness is bound to be there, you see. And therefore that darkness is going to cause something to her joy, you see. There is a darkness in terrestrial thing that will not suffer long. Too glad a note. Yeah, well, you have to have that shakti, that power also to bear, you see. On her too closed the inescapable hand. Well, that inescapable hand has to grip her also, take possession of her also. Inescapable, he cannot avoid. That is a necessity. There is a heaven shield on her. There is a bird of bliss floating above her head. Yet, this inescapable hand has to fall on her also. Because then only the problem for which she has come here can be solved. She is a mission child. Mission against something. So she has to meet that calamity, that moment. On her too close the inescapable hand. The armed immortal bore the snare of the armed immortal. Here of course stands for immortal, stands for Savitri. She is bearing the snare of time. She has stepped in the snare of time. On this immortal, the inescapable hand is going to fall. Has to fall. But she is already armed. She has done already the necessary yoga to meet the situation. That is why she is armed. She has now housed in her the divine power. And therefore she is armed already. The armed immortal bow the snare of time. Yes, she is now ready to see the situation. One dealt with her who made burdened grey. One dealt with her who meets the burdened great. The burdened great is of course Savitri here. She is the burdened great. And there is someone who is dealing with her. Who is that one? He could be that inescapable hand. He could be pain and suffering. The God of pain and suffering. He could be one who gives rise to darkness in terrestrial things. That one has been kept unspecified. But pardon me? In other words, that one is greater than all these people, than love, pain, death, that one is greater than now. It is he who is dealing with her. He is more comprehensive. Let me see what I have written down here. This line, the armed immortal bore the snare of time. Symmetrically, it's a very beautiful line. The armed is an am. Immortal, immortal, I am. Till bore, third I am. The snare, fourth I am. Of time, fifth I am. The armed immortal bore the snare of time. So, it is long, short, long, short, long, short, long, short, long, which goes on like that. Very beautiful line in the sense you see. In comparison with that, this line, on her to close the inescapable hand, metrically, on her to, I will read this line as a single phrase here, on her to is carrying a weight, on her to, so it is an anapaest, on her to, close the trochee. Inescapable, trochee, and again, hand. So this is a very complex construction. Whereas this line is purely iambic line, this one is a complex line, you see. Anapaest, trochee, pyrrhic, trochee, iamb. Anapaest, trochee, pyrrhic, trochee again, and hand, iamb. This line. The armed immortal bow the snare of time. Poetically, this is a very beautiful sentence. Honor to clothe the inescapable hand. The armed immortal bow the snare of time. There is kind of music in that, you see. Although it is talking of very sad thing. Immortal hand, sorry, the snare of time is there, inescapable hand is there, Although, but the poetry is very different, of a very elevating kind of poetry, you see. In her two clothed, inescapable hand, the armed, mortal, bow, the snare of time. See, how many R's are there? 1 R, 2 R, 3 R, 4 R here in this line, you see. Alliteration of R, you see. Okay. Now, the question is, who is this immortal? With his inescapable hand, you see. Well, to some extent, we get some idea in the next sentence here. A signer of the ordeal and the path. He is the signer of the ordeal. That armed immortal is Savitri, but that inescapable hand, he is the signer. That one is referring to the signer of the ordeal. See, these three are equivalent. Inescapable hand, this one, assigner or the ordeal.
Three.
Yeah. Inescapable hand is the same as one, referring to one. Assigner is also referring to one.
Assigner refers to one. Okay.
See, he is kind of elaborating on this, who this one is. One refers to the inescapable hand. One also refers to the assigner of the ordeal, who kind of assigns an ordeal to Savitri. And it is his hand, that of that assigner's hand, which is on Savitri now here. Now, what do they do? Assigner of the ordeal and the path. Who chooses this assigner? He is choosing this holocaust of the soul for death and fallen sorrow as the spirit's good. What is the assigner doing? He is choosing death, fall, sorrow in the case of the holocaust of the soul. The soul has holocaust, means he has plunged into this horror year. Soul has taken that. In that condition, it is this assigner who is choosing death, fall and sorrow for it. Is it clear?
No.
No, okay, I will explain to you. See, alright, you see, the first thing is inescapable hand,
yeah.
This one, then assigner, then you have here the dubious got it. All these four refer to one particular individual.
Okay. Okay. So now it's getting more clear.
All these four refer to one particular individual.
Yeah.
You see. And that is generalized by simply saying one. In this line. In other words, the inescapable hand, one, assigner and Godhead are meeting, is meeting the burdened grace. Burdened grace, Savitri, who has taken the burden of mortality. Okay, now, here, in this holocaust of the soul has plunged into the darkness. It felt a kind of a curiosity in the shadow. And it plunged. That is the holocaust of the soul. It was up there and it has plunged into the darkness here, and that is the holocaust of the soul. Means it has accepted death, fall and sorrow for a kind of a new discovery of bliss, of joy, of happiness. What is there behind the shadow? It became curious of that and it accepted this condition. So that is the holocaust of the soul. Now who chooses this assigner? Assigner has chosen false sorrow as the spirit's good. Well, it is that which is prompting the soul to make progress. It is good for the spirit to make progress, you see. In other words, the dubious Godhead with his torch of pain lit up the chasm. Now the same man, the same Godhead, now he is this darkness, this chasm which is there with his torch of pain, he is lighting the chasm. He is bringing some kind of a light to that thing and called her It is he, that assigner, that Godhead, that hand, etc., etc., called her to fill with her vast self the abyss. Means the assigner is doing something wonderful here. Okay, Savitri, this is the condition here. You alone can fill up this chasm. You alone can fill up this chasm with her vast self. So, in other words, it is a sort of a welcome thing that he has taken a positive step. Well, there is a darkness, there is chasm, there is sorrow, there is suffering, there is death, there is the holocaust of the soul and all that kind of thing. All that can go away only when Savitri can come here and fill with her vast self this abyss. That is, in short, this is what the sentence means, you see. In short or in long, what do you want to call it, you see?